Good evening, gentlemen. Today we are having a long discussion about a subject which is social media has made the world a better place. I have some facts and statistics from the article, Social Media, How Does It Affect Our Mental Health and Well-Being, which is written by Honor Reitman. The facts are got from a survey that is made by Anxiety UK. It showed that in 2012, 53% of the users claimed that their lives transferred after using social media. Moreover, 51% from the 53% stated that their lives are getting worse from social media.
Yeah, so I'm not really with that idea, but the social media, the worst about there is a lot of benefits from social media. There is a lot of people use it, but you can get information from social media, that like news, like now the social media is like a new TV, a new news.
Social media and beyond the social media will make the people have a hard time, and it makes people feel bad about themselves, because you know a lot of people come like randomly and talk to another people, like we don't know about that people, but they will be talking rude and not nice with us, and this conflict will make it hard for other people.
I disagree with you, because people on the social media, there is a lot of good things you can do. Even you can teach your children from it, using a lot of application. That depends on the people, how they are using it, in a good way or a bad way.
And the social media can be controlled. And there is a specific time, not all the time social media. If you are always in the social media, it will affect your health. But they use it in the good way.
And even if as you said, that people will write old things, you can block that contact, or do anything with it.
Other people don't know
much
about computers, but the same much on the computers or social media or any, it harms the eyes and the health, and it will make it so bad. And there's something called the blue screen that affects the eyes, and that makes people sick. So,
to add a point on my friend Shihab, one of the most negative effects that was stated by the users in the survey, they said that they lost their confidence because of the comparison that happened between each user. For example, Khaled has more followers, so I envy him. And you know, they start thinking about social media more than
commercial. They make commercial.
It's not about commercial. Like, they start thinking more about their social media lives rather than their real lives. That would affect their personality and character.
Actually, those things, people, how they are using it. Social media, you can do a lot of things about it. Different, better things, not using it and only checking the others what are they doing. Even you can share your ideas, and you can even adaptations. We contacted with a lot of people in the world.
It's like you put like put your details and what you do, maybe there's some people who like what you're doing, then we can interact with you for some business or for something. So there's a lot of them.
Can you tell me about those people who are 24/7 hours on the,
yeah,
on the phones and social media and computers, even when they are sitting with their family, they are using the
You know why? Because most of these guys are children.
There is nothing called as children.
Yeah.
We are talking about the whole world.
Yeah, we're talking about also adults.
Adults and everything. What do you think of that? That makes the health bad, and it affects the other people. It makes diseases, like mentally, and it will affect you in eventually.
Even teenagers.
Like what Sherry Turkel said about her daughter.
Yes.
Her daughter said that she was okay with social media and this stuff, but her mother was standing against her because when she sat with her, she doesn't talk with her, she doesn't do anything, and she was talking about the cons about social media and phones and computers. What do you think?
I think she can't control her daughter because she's a child. Older.
She's an adult, she's a university.
I think so.
But her mother, she knows what is right for her and what's good for her.
Yeah.
Even if she, but there is something called mother. So this, it does not make sense. I mean, yes, she can use 24, but there have to be control.
Okay, tell me about those people who are sitting with their friends.
Yes, in restaurants, maybe.
In the restaurant.
Even it's affecting studying in classes.
They don't even pay attention to that.
But how that affect when they sit down in the restaurant? They will only be there for 2 or 3 hours, and then they will go. They will not use it the whole day.
Even when they are walking, people hit each other, even when they are driving.
Yeah,
legal use and when you drive it. It's like he said, it's on the person if you want to use it or not. It does not matter if you're using social media. But social media is the most common that people use.
I am with you when you said it is against the law. But do you follow the law sometimes?
Yeah. Because you are local. You should.
A lot of people are
okay.
If you didn't,
you're going to have a fine.
Honestly, do you use seatbelts?
Yes.
Sometimes, not all the time.
Yes. But there is, like you said, there is a lot of negative. I agree with you, there is a lot of positive too. But my idea about social media is negative because it takes our time from people we like to sit with. We don't even know how to make a conversation and read love.
How about if you use it? For research about something like about any new stuff.
Yes, I'm not saying that we can't
use the internet. We're talking about social media.
While you don't have anything to do, you can use it to.
What about the cyberbullying?
Yeah.
There is a lot of people coming to you saying bad stuff. Like you said, block them. Okay, if I block one, there is a lot of people who come over and over, like Instagram. You post something. 50 million people will come and say they are coming.
Yeah, but that's the main point. You cannot block or ignore. You don't have to block a single one.
Doesn't that affect your mental state? That okay, that I am doing something good or bad. There is something okay.
Some people
say it's good. A lot of people say it's good.
It depends on the person. How
do you use it? It's a good way. For
But don't you think that it destroys real conversations? For example, I've been studying in the United States. I think they're more affected by social media, or not by social media, by texting, exactly. They don't phone call. They always text.
You know what? Because
I think it's better even if you have a
do you know,
it doesn't take.
It's not about it doesn't take time. No, like they don't know really how to.
Yeah, I agree with that point, but you know why they text? Why they all the time texting? Because they do not have a lot of activity. So
no, it's not like that. Like I wanna talk to you when I go someplace. I text you. I don't call you, Khaled. We wanna go, like you know. Because they like to edit.
So they use social media like communication.
Yeah, they like to edit their text because they're not good at going in a real conversation, you know?
Yes, unlike here. It's a bit different.
Yes.
But the major thing is, when we talked about the negative, we didn't say there is no positive. There is positives, like we said, but not as much as negative.
Yes.
One of the expert opinions is Dr. Roche. She and her team think that social media could have a negative impact on face-to-face interaction. Like what I said for you, for example, as I said, people don't know how to get in a real conversation. Because they are like they're used to text.
So this is the end because we've been talking about positives and negatives. So I think at the end of the road we are equal.
Yes, that's how we do.
Yeah, to close up, I think.
Yes.
As social,
yeah.
It's a controversial. People think that some people think that it has more negative impact. Some think that it has more positive impact.
Yeah, it's all depends on the person.
Yes. Thank you, everyone.